Welcome to Mars. Hints, such as this one, will appear throughout the training process, giving useful information on how to advance in your current tasks. You need to master the camera controls and familiarize yourself with the terrain around the prospective colony site. Now it's time to land your first rocket. With the rocket selected, designate a landing site on the indicated location. We have touchdown. The rocket has landed on Mars. Rocket carries valuable resources that will be essential for the construction and maintenance of the colony. Initially, it's best to designate a universal depot so the drones have a place to store them. Along with metals, concrete is the other vital basic construction resource. Well done. Now observe how the drones will carry all the resources to the site, and then construct the concrete extractor. Like most buildings, the concrete extractor needs power in order to operate. Having a reliable electrical grid and supply is essential for the success of the colony. Connect the Stirling generator and the concrete extractor using a power cable from the build menu to power up the extractor.
Resources are low.
Waste rock is a byproduct of all extractors and is best stored at designated locations. This way you can ensure that it will not be in the way of future construction. drones will pick pending tasks on their own within the range of the drone controllers they are assigned to. Drones run on batteries that have to be recharged periodically. Maintaining a steady supply chain between Earth and Mars is essential, especially during the early colonization stages. Don't have sufficient power for all the buildings in the colony. A system of pipes is used to deliver resources such as water and air where they are needed. Production is now underway, and the drones will begin to deliver the fuel to the rocket. Congratulations. You have finished the first tutorial. Welcome, Commander. In this training exercise, you will get acquainted with one of your most valuable tools, rovers. Now let's try moving around. The RC transport can load and carry resources around the map. Let's use it to refuel the nearby rocket. Now order the RC transport to unload the fuel next to the rocket. Some drones are left without a controller after the rocket launch. The RC transport is able to gather resources directly from surface deposits without the help of drones. Let's set up a small expand some distance away from the main base. Nice work.
Thank you.
other thing. Construct a new sensor tower to scan the nearby environment. Good job. To learn about scanning sectors and exploration. You can scan sectors of the map to discover new resources and anomalies. You can also queue sectors for scanning. Well done. Now it's time to use our fully operational RC Explorer to analyze the anomaly.
Anomaly found.
Good job. The anomaly has yielded interesting insights into new technologies. This is the research screen. From here, you can choose and queue techs for research. Another thing. Nice work. Now you know how to handle rovers. Welcome, Commander. It looks like this forward base has gone through a major dust storm. First things first, let's remove some unnecessary structures. Let's get that drone hub operational. some power, but it's not enough. We should prioritize the drone hub. We can use the machine parts left from the concrete extractor to build a wind turbine. Even with the wind turbine, there won't be enough electricity to power the base, especially during the night. You managed to get things operational, but this won't last, as buildings require maintenance, and we are out of resources. We need more metals to secure this base. Use the RC transport to collect some metals and transport them back.
Resources are low.
Good job. However, we need more than just metals. Fortunately, we can call a resupply rocket from Earth. Let's do some cleaning up around the base while we wait for the rocket to arrive. Now, let's remove some of the unnecessary cables. supplies from Earth have arrived, and we can use them to expand the base. Essential for a sustainable Martian colony. Fortunately, there is a water deposit nearby. Use the build menu to construct a water extractor near the water deposit, then power it up. Extractor is ready, but we don't have a storage for the water it will extract. Has finally come to build the first dome that will house our colonists.
Thank you.
The dome is complete, but we have to supply it with water, power, and oxygen before we can use it.
Resources are low.
Well done. You have completed the simulation successfully.